What is going on, guys? This is Knight here, bringing you a new game called Snake Pass. Now, this game, it kind of brings back my childhood memories, gives that kind of Spyro-y feel. I've already tried the game just to see if it was any good, but we're going in new, and we're going to try and 100% the game. And if I fail, I'll be doing some cuts here and there, but otherwise, we're just here to have a good time with kind of a nostalgia trip for me. You know, kind of bring back those memories with just the art style and the kind of game it is. I believe the snake's name is Noodle, and the hummingbird is Doodle. But the premise is you're playing here as Noodle the snake, who you can wrap around, you can try and wiggle up, and you're trying to collect all these orbs, coins, and then the crystals that you saw, how one was missing at the end point. We're just gonna try and collect all of those. And like I said, I am gonna try to 100% all of this as we go through. Yep, I know, Doodle, don't worry. I know to pick up speed. But before we go there, if I remember, yep, there's this right here. But then, if you go under here, there's a coin down there. Now, I wouldn't recommend going down here first, because you're not as long, you gain length as you progress and get those orbs. Oh no, no, don't fall. Wrap your head under. Maybe I can... just don't want to fall. Yep, there we go. Can I poke it? Oh, you're so cute, Noodle. But yeah, premise is basically we are trying to reactivate these portals. We aren't exactly given a reason why, or at least not that I've seen so far in the small amount of time I spent in this. Die, Noodle. Not on my watch. Come on. And you can also press Y for Doodle to pick up your tail for instances like that. Because otherwise, the more orbs you collect and coins, you get longer, which then will screw you over. But there's also one more back here, which is probably this one will give you the hardest amount of trouble, not because of getting to it. It's quite easy, as I just showed you, to get to it. It's getting back. Getting back is a pain that you will not understand. Oh my god, I somehow did it first try. You always want to step on a save plate, which are like these, or squares throughout the levels, just because you don't want to fall off and lose all your progress. But I've only played through level 1 and 2 of this game. So onward, and if you saw in the opening, there is a coin down there. But yeah, if you slither side to side, you will go faster. Which is a cool feature that they would add. Yeah, lifting your head with A, which is quite useful, especially for, like I showed you under the bridge there. And we got the save point. But yeah, it's just such a cool game. I almost feel like I'm flying right now. Oh no, it's missing a crystal. No kidding. I guess Doodle's just not strong enough to pick up the crystals. I'm guessing. We got this right over here. Oh yeah, if you try and just slither forward, you actually slow down. So we got all the blue things as shown. We're gonna try and just master this. Sometimes it is better to use sometimes it is better to use Doodle's head just to reach out and nab something. But here is the red crystal. And you can hit select at any time to both see how many, or is it start, to see how many coins, how many blue orbs, and how many crystals. As you can see, we have gotten everything, so we are heading out. We have all the key pieces up. There we go, flying off. Whew. Perfect score in Paradise Path. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna do one more because that was a tad bit short. We're gonna do Courtyard Chamber also. I was removed from the non-existent party I was apparently a part of. Why wasn't I invited? Anyway, we're loading up this one. Let's see how it goes. I really like the music of this game. So we're at Courtyard Chamber? I haven't gotten, like I said, this is the furthest I got was this level, and I did this level as well, but just trying to understand what the story is. I'm assuming it'll become more obvious the further we go on. Any like secret things? Nope. I don't quite remember where everything is. Or at least I don't think I do. I might. I'll have to check out. Didn't even need to really wrap around that. There's stuff off in that direction. It wants us to go that way, but I'm gonna go up here first. And you always wanna look in like nooks and crannies, like over there. Now here's a... Sometimes you can't quite make it, so you just wrap around and then loop more. Nothing over there. Like I said, you're just double checking everywhere, just in case. Okay, I see that doodle. No duh. One thing you want to be careful about is in these early levels, Doodle will try to tell you to do a lot, and if you're like on an edge, like where you could slide off, and he does that, you will just fall right off. He has no cares. I saw one over there. Wait. that part of a different area? Yeah, it is. We could jump. I'll show you all of it in order. It's finagly controls at first, but you get used to it rather quickly. Oh. And there we go. Okay. Trying to remember where exactly everything is. I don't think there's anything off the edge yet. Yet being the key word here. Aw, sneaky one. Would miss that one otherwise. Oh yeah, there's these. I don't know what they do. But they make a noise when you hit them. Oh, do we have to get up there? I know I can, like, force my way up there, but I'm not gonna. Oh. Hmm? There's that right there. Nothing secret about that, so we'll slither through here and out onto the first checkpoint. Now, I would definitely recommend this, especially if you had Spyro, like, in your childhood. It was... Oh no! You don't say, Doodle. Now, I remember there was, like, some achievement, I think, on this map that was, like, get two of the keystones without touching the ground. And I tried for, like, maybe a good 30-some minutes. Couldn't figure it out. Grab this one in the water. It's always a good idea to double-check behind stuff just in case. And we're gonna go up here before we forget. This is an area I almost missed because, you know, I rushed forward. And as you can see, his weight will slow him down some. This literally just... raise your head and pop out. Sometimes you don't need to wrap around. I just do it just for the safety and that because if you don't, oh god. And if you don't hit a checkpoint, you know, before you, god dang it, Noodle. Okay, we'll do it your way then. If you don't hit a checkpoint before and you lose all your stuff, then you're gonna be angry, then you're not gonna wanna play. You know, and that's no good. God dang it. Okay. One more try before we get a nice hard cut. One thing is realizing when to raise his head and when not, so you can, like, wrap around like that. But now we're out here. I don't believe there's anything over here. But it's a good viewpoint. I would definitely keep lookout for viewpoints on maps, because then you can get bird's eye view and try to see a hidden secret that you might have otherwise missed. I believe that... Oh, there's one right there. That one you have to jump, I believe. So, let me crawl back up here real quick. Hopefully this time it won't take... Noodle, what are you doing? Hopefully this time it won't take... God dang it. Oh, this game just... The music, I'm not even mad that, you know, like I fell right then. He's just so cute. And we're up. Jump, Noodle, jump! Oh, we could. We could have climbed up right there. Oh well. Got one down here that I kind of remembered. And then we're off to the water. Do you swim faster in the water? You hold your breath. I might go for all achievements, or maybe like in a separate video show you how to get some of the more harder ones. But right now we're just playing through the levels, trying to master them all. Like I said, this is the last level where I actually, for the most part, know where everything is. And it took me much longer than what I'm showing you to figure all this out as well. Yeah, I get that it's up there. But first things first, if you slither right on over here, you'll have a nice coin hanging down for you. And there's a little secret here. Just slither all your body up against the wall and just slowly lower your head down. You don't even have to worry about, you know, silly climbing. Can we just crawl right up here? We can. Of course, it would be helpful if I had Doodle, but oh well. That's three of the coins. Not quite, but there we go, one keystone. We're off this way down the river now. And this is another good instance. He pulls you back into how to climb again. I was trying to jump across, doing the achievement without touching the ground, climbing on the railing, and I was like right on the railing. And he did that, and I just slid straight off. There we go. Got the first one. But sneakily up here, this coin, not even that well hidden, to be honest with you. But we'll get it. And we will jump back. We got yellow up there. Yes, I get it. I know how to climb, Doodle. Don't worry. Need one more of those, which is right over here. And like I said before, the control scheme for this game can definitely be a frustrating one to understand at first. You gotta get used to Noodle's movements, I'd say. Especially like in moments like this where you need him to wrap around something. There we go. Think we can jump? Nope. And sometimes you can just slither on top like this without even having to wrap around. Now, is that everything? No, we are missing a coin. Where could that coin be? I wonder. Is it off the edge? No. This is probably one of those super sneakily hidden coins. But let's activate the gate real quick. We aren't gonna go in quite yet though. We need to find this last. Was it up there? It might have been up there with the yellow one. Might have just been an idiot. Yep, here it is. Just go straight out, raising your head, of course. And then, you know, drop your weight. No. Because I haven't saved in a tiny bit, so I don't want to fall off, losing everything. And you can always backtrack to checkpoints if need be. But here we are. Sliding into the portal, got everything, yeah. Whee! Everything, all the gemstones, all the blue orbs, and all the coins. Anyways, let's see, is that all? Yep, we're on to Gatekeeper's Gardens. I'm gonna leave that off here, guys. If you're enjoying this, please hit that like button down below. Or if you want to see more Xbox One content, or what is this, Sneak Snake? What the hell is this game called? I feel really bad now. Snake Pass. If you want to see more Snake Pass, then hit that subscribe button down below. But this is Knight, and have yourself a good evening.